Getting to know them personally with interviews on Rock Made of Metal.
Hi guys, I'm Fredrick and I play guitar in Opeth.
And right now, let's kind of talk about the tour that you're on right now, just for general information's sake as well too. Can you tell us, give a little bit of info about that as well?
Well, the tour, well, tonight is the fourth show we do, and it's been going good so far. We put a lot of time into sorting out the guitar rigs this time around. We tried to pick a lot of songs we haven't played for the previous tours. So there's a lot of stuff there, like the new songs and a lot of old stuff, really heavy stuff as well in there. We play Advent from the second album, for instance, and haven't played that for a while, and it's really fun. I think it comes along really good, the blend mix with that and the new songs as well. In a live perspective, it just gives the setlist more diversity.
Well, do the audience feel like that then, when they're hearing the new stuff? I mean, how's the reaction been when you've been playing the new stuff?
Seems good, I think. We start the set with a couple of new tracks, and usually when people haven't heard the album much, they're a bit like a question mark or something. But it seems like people dig it. Yeah, we get a see about it tonight.
You seem a little bit quite shocked by that. You were like, oh, it seems quite. They seem to dig it. Like,
well, you never know. You can never take things for granted, can you?
Well, it must be a little bit nicer as well too, compared to the, you know, obviously Pale Communion kind of still goes down that kind of, I'll call it for progressive rock, for, you know, naming sake, but, you know, it kind of goes down that route a little bit more, so it must be nice to at least have an audience that's a bit used to that, as opposed to like heritage.
Yeah, I mean, it would have been strange in a way if we would have done a very metal album straight after Heritage. So I think this album goes a bit hand in hand, even though it's different. Pale Communion is different compared to it, but I know the fans are a bit divided. Some people don't like that kind of era and some don't, but I guess a lot of people that listen to Opeth has a bit of an open mind. They kind of understand.
They've kind of just kind of come more to accept then that, you know, compared to last album, it's only four shows in, but this album tour compared to the Heritage album tour, I mean, are people just like going with it a lot more then?
I think it seems like they're really interested in listening to the new stuff as well. All the shows now, after we were done, they seemed really happy, you know. They get their fair share of the older stuff, and we're not pushing the new stuff too much. Like, for instance, when we did the first Heritage tour, we decided no songs with growls, and a lot of people were, of course, disappointed with that. So we talked about it, and we thought maybe we pushed it a little bit too far, because it's one thing when it comes to recording stuff, but in the live thing, we want people to go out from the place, be happy.
Yeah, absolutely, because like that's one of the things I've read about as well. I mean, like, you're definitely a band that cares, when you're in the studio, you care about what you want, and rightly so at the end of the day as well, but I mean, so on this tour then, is it kind of a little bit like more kind of the fan engagement then, as opposed to like the last tour then a little bit, or?
Yeah, I would say, in a way. Okay. We still play a lot of, we enjoy playing all these songs, you know. That's the main reason.
It's not. Hope you do.
Stray away from that era, it's a huge part of Opeth, and I love that era too. It's really fun to play the heavier stuff. But also a challenge to playing the new stuff, because it has a lot of singing, and it's are different in many ways.
I mean, one of the things I was kind of reading as well too was just about mixed feelings towards touring as well too. By any chance, do you have anything like that when you're touring?
I mean, if we wouldn't appreciate playing the shows, you shouldn't do this work, even though you're very privileged to be able to do this for a living. But we still absolutely enjoy playing the shows. Okay. And of course, there's always two sides to the coins when it comes to touring, you being away from family and all that, but it's our job, you know, it's what we do. But this time around, we don't tour as long periods as we did before. A lot of us have small kids back home, so we try to be away just maximum 4 weeks, and then home for a week, and then go again.
So you must have isn't this a long tour that you're on right now then, by any chance?
Yeah, but we have actually three shows now left here in the UK, and then we go back home for a week, and then we have 3 weeks in Europe.
Okay, sure.
So it's a bit more breaks tucked in between this time around.
No problem at all. Alright, well, I was just wanting to move on to something else, because like when I was kind of doing the research for like this interview as well too, one of the things I kind of, like, there was a theme I kind of noticed a lot of, and I know you get this a lot as well too, of kind of like, kind of the metal community and stuff like that as well too, kind of coming in and stuff like that, and one of the things I was just, first of all, kind of general thoughts of kind of like the metal, what the kind of metal community scene is like in general. I was just wondering what your thoughts on that before.
Well, in a way, I don't keep myself super updated. I don't go through everything stuff that gets released, you know. So I think there's a lot of great bands out there, absolutely. A lot of interesting stuff. Okay. But the latest bands, I don't keep very good track of, to be honest. It's like when I'm back home, I spend most of the time just playing myself instead of listening to music. The time when I listen more to music is when we're on the road, when I travel. So back home, it's more, if I'm, yeah, put some music onto my daughter, but that can be children's music or whatever. So it's difficult question for me to give a proper updated answer to.
I mean, well, that's kind of something I was going to question, because obviously with your ties in kind of the metal community as well too and stuff like that, if you're kind of heading towards this new direction, I mean, is it kind of hard to move on with kind of like a newer sound, but still be so connected to the metal community to the point where it's like they're kind of holding on to you for kind of your life?
I know what you're saying. I think Opeth is very privileged in that sense. We can experiment, but that thing has been with Opeth really since the first album, in a way. But so I think people are a bit open-minded with Opeth, and we can still play. We played some festivals where it tends to be more jazz, prog, rock, and then we usually play the more death metal stuff. And then we played some extreme metal festivals, like Brutal Assault, and then we played more of the softer stuff. Just to mess with people. Which is a bit odd, I guess, but...
Just throw them off guard.
So, I mean, we can do a really heavy set list if we like, and we can blend it up and we can do more.
But is that the direction you want to go in, though? Like, is that ever something that you want to do when you're on stage, to have, like, to be... Well, I mean, you can, but do you want to do that?
I think it's... if it's only the extremely heavy, I tend to get a bit bored. I like dynamics. Yeah. And what we're trying to do now with this set list is we create, like, a V-shaped set list. So we start off pretty heavy, and then gets a bit spaced out in the middle, and then you build it up again, that kind of thing. I think one thing is, we don't really know what's going to happen in the future. Next album can be something completely different.
Have you guys even got to that part yet?
No, not really, but we... Even Mike said it could be something completely different.
Could we have a One Direction album by any chance?
That's what we're aiming for, but don't tell anyone.
One Opeth. No.
Hello, I'm Fredrick, and I play guitar in Opeth, and you're watching Rock Made of Metal. And if you like to subscribe, you can click down here, or if you like to watch a video, it's over there.